be wise in your own eyes, meaning going by what you think you should do, but go by what God says. And I want you to know, there is a standard in the kingdom of God.
I have a question for that.
Go ahead.
When you do not be wise in your own eyes, like
yes.
when God tells you to go to church and you go to the crack house instead of that, you're not doing what God's saying.
Yes.
You have to do what God's saying, then you will be able to get the blessing that you do. If God tells you to do it and you do it, you have to keep on doing the things that he tells you to do, and boom. There's a blessing.
Amen. Out of the mouth of babes. This young brother has such a bright future. Listen, excuse me. We've got to learn even from the young. That was profound. Let's go further. So it says, be not wise in your own eyes. Stop going to the crack house. Wherever you're going is not what God would have you to do. Amen. And it says, when you do that, it will be health to your navel and marrow to your bones. Hey, listen, when you begin to line yourself up to the word of God, it literally produces healing in your body. The word of God is alive and it works like medicine, so that as you acknowledge God, as you fear him and depart from evil, and when you begin to humble yourself beneath the mighty hand of God, when you begin to say, you know what, his way is better than my way. And so I'm not going to be wise in my own eyes, but rather I'm going to depart from the lifestyle choices that I've been making. Guess what? He will begin to direct your path. And when he does that, it will produce healing in your body.
And when you be wise in your own eyes, you will not, like, your inside will become darker and darker if you don't listen to what God is saying.
Wow.
Because when you listen to God, what's saying, your body will get lighter and lighter. But if you don't, your body will get darker and darker. And then when time is out, you won't be able to have more time. Your time will be up, and that's it.
And what happens when a person's time is up and they haven't served God and they weren't with God? What happens to that person?
They will burn in hell.
That's right. Wow. Amen. All right.
Some of you people may not believe in hell, but now when your time has run up, you are now going to see that it's real. There's no change in your mind that I want to go back to God, because you're stuck down there for life. You can't leave.
That is so right. So it's time to make the right choice now. So you heard it from the young preacher. Guess what? You have to make a choice, and you should make a choice while you still can. Amen.